Hey everyone, in the past week I've spoken to loads of different people who've had their computers broken, in many cases temporarily, but in some cases permanently, due to enabling Secure Boot to play Battlefield 6. And the reason I know a lot about this is a year and a half ago, I went through the same things myself with enabling Secure Boot and having issues, so I published a video on it. And usually that video gets like 1 to 200 views a day. But the moment the Battlefield 6 came out, that video started getting thousands of views. And remember, that video isn't a general one saying, here's how to enable Secure Boot. It's one saying, here's what to do if you've enabled Secure Boot and your computer is completely buggered. So in other words, thousands of people are finding themselves or their computers in this position every single day, which sucks. So in this video, I just wanted to talk about that a bit and give a little bit of advice about what you could try and also rant a little bit. So firstly, why are Battlefield 6 requiring Secure Boot? The reason they need Secure Boot to be on is to cut down on the number of cheaters, and in general, I think this is a good thing, even though there's some collateral damage that I'll talk about in a minute. I think it's a good thing because ages ago I booted up an old Battlefield game, just for nostalgia's sake, and immediately I went into a game and was getting one-shotted by bots on the other side of the map who had shotguns, and that sucks, like I couldn't play the game at all, because it was filled with just bots and nothing else. So by Battlefield saying we need Secure Boot to be on, that allows the developer EA Games to have certain kernel-level anti-cheat programs that should in theory cut down or eliminate the number of cheaters in the game. And in theory that's a good thing, but the reality is that enabling Secure Boot for many people is quite a difficult thing. Like, many people have never gone into the BIOS and would never want to go into the BIOS, so I can kind of understand that people might be scared about it. And also, even if you have been into the BIOS before, it's often not as easy as just going in and enabling Secure Boot and then getting on with your life. For example, if Windows is installed as MBR, you have to firstly convert your Windows install to be GBT before you can actually enable Secure Boot. Equally, if you've got BitLocker enabled, then you might find that enabling Secure Boot might actually lock you out of your system, and you better hope that you've got your BitLocker recovery key available, otherwise you won't be able to access your system. So that completely sucks, and that's why my video that I published a year and a half ago has suddenly gone from hundreds of views to thousands of views a day because people are just enabling Secure Boot and then finding the Windows is not starting up anymore. So yeah, what can you do about it? Well, firstly, you could hope that Battlefield changes their mind and says, hey, you don't need Secure Boot anymore, don't worry about it. I think that's very, very unlikely. So your other option is just not play the game, which isn't really ideal because it does seem like a really good game, but you could just boycott it, fair enough. Although I would say that many more games are starting to require Secure Boot. So even if you boycott this one, what you might find is in a few years' time, there's more and more games, especially online ones, that are requiring Secure Boot to be on. So at some point you might need to bite the bullet and enable Secure Boot. But yeah, if you have enabled it and you're having loads of issues, there's a few things you should try. So I talk about this more in my other video, but one of the main things you should do is try plugging your computer in with a HDMI cable, not a DisplayPort cable, because what people are finding is they're enabling Secure Boot, and then when they restart, there's no output appearing on their monitors. And for some reason, using a HDMI cable is actually leading to better results than with DisplayPort, especially if you have integrated graphics and you plug the HDMI cable into your motherboard. That can often then show some sort of error message on the screen that then allows you to get into the BIOS and debug things and fix things. So that is something worth trying. Equally, if you have enabled Secure Boot and your system is just in a completely screwed up state, you could try removing the CMOS battery and leave it out for like 10 minutes or whatever, and that can help clear out the BIOS settings, and then hopefully you can, after putting the CMOS battery back in, you can reboot the system and hopefully fix things or convert Windows or do what you need to do. But if you can't find your CMOS battery, some motherboards actually have a clear CMOS header where you then put like a screwdriver on it to bridge that sort of header, and that can then clear the CMOS on your motherboard as well, and that can then allow you to start up as well. So there are some things to try. I've also spoken to some people who have said that actually if you've got like 2 or 3 or 4 sticks of RAM, remove most of them and just end up with 1 stick of RAM and try booting up with that, because some people have found that that actually helps after enabling Secure Boot, that yeah, they've tried everything else and that is the one thing that works. But to be honest, if you're finding that, you know, you're getting some output on your monitor, but Windows is stuck in a buggy state, it's constantly doing automatic repairs and stuff, my advice is, unfortunately, to just reformat the drive and start again. And it sucks that you might have to actually do this, but this is why I tend to say you should always keep backups before you make any major change to your system. So that's what I'd recommend, but it completely sucks that you've got to do this. And in theory, the goal of game developers saying you need Secure Boot to be on, that's an admirable goal because cheaters suck and they suck the enjoyment out of games. But at the same time, I think what they're not completely realizing is some motherboards are just buggy. Like, there's somebody who actually had to go and buy a brand new motherboard because trying to enable Secure Boot just completely corrupted things. And it completely sucks that people are having to buy brand new hardware due to just enabling a setting to try and play a game. It's all very well and good for EA Games to say, here's how you enable Secure Boot. But in reality, I think it is worth acknowledging and repeating that some motherboards are just buggy, they have buggy BIOSes or whatever else that means that when you try and enable secure boot, people end up in a situation where their computer isn't booting up or showing output or Windows corrupts, and that completely sucks. So hopefully that can be ironed out, especially before Battlefield 6 launches on the 10th of October. It seems like a really, really good game. I've been really enjoying it after enabling secure boot, but yeah, it is a pain that people are going through this. And that wraps up this video. If you've got any comments, I'd love to hear from you. And if your system did end up in a really messed up state due to enabling secure boot, I'd love to hear from you, and especially let me know your motherboard model, because I'm trying to put together a list of motherboards or manufacturers that might be more affected when you enable secure boot. If you enjoyed this video though, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.